Hello everyone, my name is Tianlein and today we talk about the new upcoming holiday event, the New Life Festival 2017 in the Elder Scrolls Online. We still have to wait for an official announcement to know exactly in detail what will happen in the upcoming event, but I wanted to share with you my experience from the last New Life Festival 2016 and show you all the rewards that you could earn. Since the last holiday events worked similar to the events last year, I assume that the New Life Festival will probably not have many changes too. In case you are only interested in a specific topic, please take a look in the description. The most important question is probably, when will the New Life Festival start? After I read the descriptions of the upcoming Crown Store items, my guess is that the event will start on the 14th of December and last until the 2nd January. Last year you had to acquire the free New Life Festival scroll from the Crown Store to start the event. After you read the scroll, you have to travel to Breda, which you can find in Eastmarch. North of the Kindesgrove Frey Shrine, you will find Breda's tent. There, you will not only find Breda, but also a cake with Breda's magnificent meat. If you drank from the cake, you got a double experience buff for 2 hours, and you had to come back every 2 hours to refresh the XP buff. We will see if the experience buff process works this year similar. To start the New Life Festival quest, we have to speak to Breda. She will offer you every day 9 unique New Life Festival quests, which you can do once per day with each of your characters. Breda gives you the quests in a random order, but you will be able to obtain every quest every day during the holiday event. Each quest is themed for Tamriel's different races and located in their respective zones. The Castle Charm Challenge is a Breton tradition. For that you have to travel to the northwestern part of Stormhaven. Here you have to visit Alcair Castle and entertain the people at the marked areas on your map. Last year you had to perform in the Old Goat Inn, then at the Alcair Marketplace, and finally you had to show your performance in the castle itself. The Fishbone Feast is an Argonian tradition. Travel to the southern park of Shadowfen to the percolating Maia Ray Shrine. Here we have to catch some fishes at the marked New Life fishing holes on your map. You can use any bait to catch these fishes. The fishing place near Hissimir was last year always pretty crowded. You can also find more New Life fishing places along the coast to the east. After you caught a Histmark Blobfin, a Shadowfen Creeping Leech, and a Black Marsh Cucumber, speak to Gentleheart in Hissimir, which will prepare the fishes. The Lava Food Stomp is a Dunmer tradition. For this quest you have to travel to Stone Falls and dance in some taverns. First you have to go to Devon's Watch and perform a dance in a Watch House tavern. For the next dance you have to go to the Fish Sting Tavern, which is near the harbor of Devon's Watch. Next you have to go to the city Ebonheart, to the Ebony Flask, and perform there your dance. The last location is in the Town Hall of Ebonheart. Go inside the Town Hall and go downstairs for your last dance performance. The Mudball Merriment is a Bosmer tradition. This quest will send you to Skywatch in Auridon, and you have to throw 10 mudballs on NPCs or other players. After you completed this first task, you have to go to the Skywatch Manor. Inside the manor, go to the first room on the right. There, you have to throw mud balls on any of the 3 Alliance Ambassadors. The Signal Fire Sprint is a Redguard tradition. Visit Bergama in the southern part of Alikir Desert. Speak to Obatha to start the quest. You must light now 4 Signal Fires in 55 seconds to complete the quest. The timer will start once you light the first fire, and you can also do this quest in a group. Once you lit the fires within the time limit, return to Obatha. The Snow Bear Plunge is a Nord tradition. To complete this quest, you have to jump into freezing water at the highlighted spots on your map. First, you have to go to the docks in the eastern part of Windhelm. Once you are there, jump into the water. If you want to remove the freezing status effect, go to the fire nearby and warm yourself up. For the second jump, go to the bridge, which leads into Windhelm. Jump off the bridge into the water and then warm yourself up at the fire. The final place is the Dead Man's Fall, which is west of Windhelm. Go to the top of the waterfall and jump down. The Stone Tooth Bash is an Orc tradition. This quest will send you to Stone Tooth Fortress in Bednik. Matron Borbuga asks you to collect meat and honey. You can obtain meat by killing wolves, mud crabs or rabbits, and from giant wasps you can obtain honey. After you return to Matron Borbuga, you have to eat and drink from the marked dishes and drinks, and show your appreciation for the feast with a belch. The Trial of Five Clawed Guile is a Khajiit tradition. Travel to Walkar in Reaper's March and speak with Tomira. Unlock the 3 nearby locked chests and take the coins inside before the time runs out. War Orphan Sojourn is an Altmer tradition. Visit the Temple of the Eight in Cradwood, which is northwest of Eldenroot, and speak to Ormurel. You can complete this quest pretty quick by donating a small amount of gold, but you can also help with killing encroaching wildlife. Each time you want to complete a New Life Festival quest, you have to return to Breda in Eastmarch, and you will receive a New Life gift box. These gift boxes can contain different rewards. For example, you can find a selection of crafting materials, unique recipes, skin change emotive chapters, and special collectibles. Additionally, you could obtain various consumable emote items. For example, the disposable Swallower Sword, disposable Juggling Knives, Fire Brothers Oil Bun, or the Mud Ball. Now I will show you the special recipes which you could collect last year at the New Life Festival. The Alike Festival Sword Pie, All That Mary Orphan Gruel, Rajin's Sugar Claws, Snow Bear Glow Wine, Bergama Warning Fire, Batnik Twice Spiked Ale, Jagger Drenched Mud Ball, Lava Foot Soup and Saltress, and the Hissimir Fish Eye Rye, which will let fishing holes glow so you can see them faster from distance. And additionally, it will tell you what type of fishing hole you have found. Another possible reward are the Skin Changer Style Chapters, and also its crafting material, Wolfsbane Incense. As far as I remember, it dropped last year frequently, and the guild traders got flooded with the motive chapters. So if you miss at the end of the event some chapters, you can probably buy them pretty cheap at the guild stores. In case you want to see more of the Skin Changer Style, you can take a look at my showcase video, which I will link in the description below. Last year you could also collect various collectibles. The Kolovian Filiquet Hood and the Kolovian Fur Hood are two hats which you can add to your wardrobe. Additionally, you can receive the Nordic Brothers Tal costume, which is perfect for a jump into the icy river in Eastmarch. Inside the New Life gift boxes you can also find the Mudball Pouch Memento, which allows you to throw mudballs on NPCs or players. If you own already these collectibles, you can also sell them via the guild trader or trade or give them to other players. Of course, you can also buy these items at the guild store too, if you don't find any in your New Life gift boxes. Sadly, I don't know if they will add new collectibles to the New Life gift boxes. For that, we have to wait some days for the official New Life Festival announcement. In case you didn't participate last year at the New Life Festival, or didn't find the time to complete all the achievements, you should maybe try to complete them this year. For completing all quests from Breda, you will receive a new die, the New Life Cerulean. And if you manage to complete all New Life related achievements, you will earn the Magnaminos title. You should also take a look at the Crown Store, since you can find the unique items during the New Life Festival too. From the 14th December to the 2nd January, you can buy the Starim Frostcaster Style. This is a Crown Store exclusive style, and you are not able to find the style in-game. Last year you could purchase the Starim Frostcaster Style for 2000 crowns. In case you want to take a closer look at this style, you can watch my showcase of the Starim Frostcaster Style, which I will link in the description. From the 21st December until the 2nd January, you can purchase a festive horse, the Winter Garland Dapple Grey. Additionally, you can get different new winter themed hats. The Winter Broadrim Hat Pack contains the Winter Corsage, Winter Garland and Winter Wreath Broadrim Hat. This bundle is available from the 14th December to the 2nd January. The New Life's Monk Cap and Sundust Winter Hood are available from the 18th December until the 21st December. Last year you could buy these hats for 500 crowns per item. And the New Life Festival Cap is available from the 21st December until the 2nd January. Last year the New Life Festival Cap costed 500 crowns. Since you get a double XP buff at the New Life Festival, it is also a perfect opportunity to level up fast and easy new characters. If you need some tips how you can earn even more experience beside of the double XP buff, I will link my XP boost guide in the description below. Hopefully you enjoyed my overview of the New Life Festival and what kind of rewards you can receive. I'm looking forward to this holiday event since I had last year a lot of fun. I liked the most the Snowbeer Plunge quest, and which quest did you enjoy the most? It would be awesome if you subscribe, like or leave me a comment. Have a good day and until next time, tschüss!